Like a garden club.
There you go, your new bag. Sturdy.
This is Eyes on New Jersey News.
Good afternoon, John Edmonds from Eyes on New Jersey News. I'm once again back in Trenton, New Jersey, just outside New Jersey Weedman's Joint. NJWEEDMAN'S Joint opened in 2015 to serve as a temple, and the other half served as a restaurant. Now, customers ranged from lawyers to politicians to gypsies and free-spirited folk. Now, in 2016, the restaurant owner, Ed Fortune, who's also known as NJWEEDMAN, was arrested and held without bail in the Mercer County Correctional System for 447 days. After found not guilty, Ed immediately returned to his profession he knew best, selling marijuana. While Governor Murphy has ordered the closure of all non-essential businesses, statewide dispensaries have been considered essential and have remained open. Now, Fortune, who operates on the black market level, believes his business is essential as well. Let's ask him why.
Weed is essential.
I believe marijuana is essential. Not so much the business. I don't believe that the ATCs should just be essential. I believe the black market. I believe weed should be essential.
NJWEEDMAN, the restaurant owner in Trenton, New Jersey, believes the black market of cannabis serves New Jersey smokers better than the state's medical marijuana program.
The black market is providing. There's 800,000 people in the state of New Jersey who smoke on a regular basis. And the ATCs can't handle that. The black market has been handling it for a long time. And now in this crisis era, that's what we're doing.
See just how Ed is faring in this new COVID-19 world.
I'm keeping some separation. That's what the plastic wall is about. I wear masks and gloves. I encourage everyone to come with masks and gloves. People who come with masks and gloves, I give a gift to. The money I keep separate. The people who come here, generally, there are some people who have medical cards and they come to me because it's cheaper. And they don't have to wait in lines around the block. And then there are people who don't have medical cards, but they smoke weed, and this is a safer place. They're not buying it off the street. I built it, and they came. I think people should support the black market anyway. Even if it's not me, there are plenty of people just like me around the state that are providing, have been providing for a long time. Now that legalization is coming, I think people should support the black market.
While the restaurant NJWEEDMAN'S Joint is keeping hungry folks content, the cannabis sales are also flourishing.
Well, my cooks, they're still running the kitchen and everything. You can get a turkey burger, you can get chicken wings, you can get whatever you want. I just provide, and I think it's a service. I'm providing a service for the potheads. I mean, for the 5 years I've been here, I've constantly said that I cater to the cannabis consuming community. The regular business hours for the restaurant is constant. It's 10 a.m. to 8 p.m. For me, back here, 2 p.m. to 8 p.m. on Thursday and Sunday.
NJWEEDMAN feels like he is David in the biblical fight of David and Goliath as he continues to operate inside the black market underworld.
I demand legalization, not corporatization. Legalization for all. Include the black market. That's all. Include the black market. During this time of COVID, you have to take some protections, but weed is essential.
With long lines and poor service from competition, the black market could very well be deemed essential as well. In regards to viral contraction of coronavirus, as well as all other deadly viruses, please remember to wash your hands, practice your social distancing, and avoid touching the face when outside. From the capital city, just outside NJWEEDMAN'S Joint, I've been John Edmonds for Eyes on New Jersey News.
Be sure to stay up to date with all our live